Hi, good morning, Facebook. We don't have anybody on yet. Happy Tuesday. I think you guys will be able to see okay there. Good morning. My name is Courtney. I'm at Denver Dance Authority here in Colorado. Nobody's on yet. I'm going to be doing a barre workout. So all you need is something for stability. So if you don't have a barre, that's A-okay. You can use the back of a chair. You can use the back of a couch, maybe a countertop. And then what we'll do is as I switch sides, I'm actually going to move my barre from one side to the other. And you have the option to do that as well. Or you can just walk around. But if you are going to use something that you can't move, something not portable, say like a countertop, or like a patio ledge, then I'll give you an opportunity to move your device to the other side so that you can stay with me, okay? You don't need any equipment, you don't need shoes. Shoes are completely optional. It's actually best to go barefoot. This is a ballet dance-based class, so we'll do a lot of flexing, a lot of pointing, and to get that full effect, it's best to go with no shoes on. So we'll go ahead and get started. I'm gonna go through all of the positions that you'll see. I'm gonna turn some background music on. Hopefully it doesn't get too loud and you can still hear me, but I am gonna move to the beat of the music. So feel free to move at your own pace. First position, your heels are together and your toes are externally rotated. Second position is gonna be the exact same thing. Our feet are just gonna be wider than the hips, okay? It's a posture-based class, so I don't care how low you go. We're gonna think about keeping our shoulders over our hips as we move. And I always like to say, just imagine that you're pressed against a wall and ask yourself as you're moving, do all parts of your back from the shoulders to the tailbone touch that wall, okay? We'll go ahead and get started. I'm gonna crank the music up. Just make sure you have lots of room to move around. Make sure you have a towel nearby. And again, all you need is something for stability. Welcome to barre. My name is Courtney. Here we go. All right. I don't know if you guys can hear that, but if you can't hear the music, I like to use 128 beats per minute. So feel free to go and find your own playlist and mute me, and you can just follow along with your own music. We're going to start off in first position, heels together. Bring your hands to the hips. Take your shoulders up, back, and down. Really lift the chest and squeeze the belly into your spine. We'll close and open the feet here. Close, open, close, and open. So right now we're moving from our hip, not the knee. You want to give me that full rotation. Close and open. Let's do two more. We're going to leave those feet open. Bring it on the toes. Lift and lower. Just releve and lower. Releve and lower. So releve just means to rise. We'll use this as a progression. Do you always have the option to keep your feet planted on the floor? A few more. Four, three, two. We're going to take our heels halfway. Hold it and pulse. exhale, pull your shoulder blades apart. Inhale as you open the heart to the sky. Exhale and inhale. Exhale. Take it back, circle backwards. keep our gaze on the floor so that the neck stays in line with the spine. I want you to keep your arms in tight, your biceps glued into those ears. And we're going to take this extended leg and cross it behind our standing for four, three, two, tap the floor and lift straight up. Control it. Do it again. Down four, three, two. We go down at an angle and then lift straight up. Just a little faster. and lower. Lift the heels, bend the knees, stand tall and lower. Releve, plie, stand tall and lower. Beautiful job. Let's do one more. I want you to bring it down and hold it. Hold it, hold it. Find a little pulse. So right now my shoulders are directly over the hips. You're just pressed against that wall. You're squeezing the inner thighs. You're squeezing the heels. Squeezing the belly. We're going to hold it here. I want you to open, close. Open, close. Just opening and closing the knees. Feel it in those inner thighs. Keep those heels touching. Don't let them come apart. If you're feeling really good this morning, let's go down for two. Down, two, and lift. Two, three more. Just sliding straight up and down that wall. We're there, guys. One more. All right. Go ahead and walk it back. Find your 90-degree angle. Take any stretch that your body needs. We're going to go ahead and switch it over. So I'm going to move my bar to the other side. You may have the option where you can just walk around to the other side. You're going to come up to second position. And then if you need, if you're using, say, something that doesn't move, I'll give you just a few moments if you need to take your device to the other side. Go ahead and open up second position. Come down and pulse. So we'll be here for just a moment. That way, if you are setting up on the other side, you have time and you can just catch up with us. So we're in second position. Just wiggle your toes. Roll those shoulders back. All right. So we should all be ready to start moving again. We're going to start by bending our knees, loading our legs, hold it low, wiggle those toes. Now the opposite arm comes across to the bar, overhead. Opening that space between the ribs and the hips. All right, let's go a little bit faster. Pick up that tempo, you reach in second. Reach in second. Just taking that arm overhead. Don't have to touch your bar. Just reach as far as you can go. One more. Second position, hold it, and pause. Woo! All right, we're going to do a little movement through the legs. Go ahead, turn your toes forward. We're going away from the bar, towards the bar, and we're going to reach those arms overhead. You can go a little bit faster. Feel free to move at your own pace, though. Let's do two more. Last one. Come back to second position. Rotate those toes. Bring it down and pulse. Now you're going to take your hands to heart center. Shoulders back and down. Wiggle your toes. We're going to hold this pulse. Lift your right heel. Three, two, and switch. For four. Three, two, and switch. Four. Three, two, and switch. Last one. Now, lower your heels. Rotate in towards your bar. All 10 toes face your bar. We're going to come down and pulse. And maybe you want your bar. Maybe you want to just take those arms overhead. Relax your shoulders. Three pulses, and then we'll point that back toe. Here we go. Three, two, one, point. Three, two. Rest those elbows. Your hips face the floor. Three, two, one, point your toe. We have four more. Three, two, one. One more. We're going to stay on the bar. Hold it here. Point your toe. Find that little pulse. If you have a soft bend in your standing leg, we're just pushing our weight into the elbows on the bar. About 15 seconds. It doesn't matter how high you lift your leg, as long as it's straight. Those hips are facing the floor. For four. For three. Two. And one. Walk it back. Find your 90-degree angle. Give me a nice flat back. Push the chest to the floor. This time we're going to extend our other leg. Give me a nice straight line from the hip to the toe.
Keep those shoulders stacked, really push into the floor. One more, we're gonna go 8 singles. Here we go, pick it up, 4, 8, 7, 6, woo. 4 more, 2 more. We're gonna tap that toe on the floor, come off your bar, reach overhead, open that space, come back down, grab your bar and lift. 3, 2, 1, tap the floor, reach overhead.
Extend our arm. You're gonna give me 3 pulses and then we'll take the arm overhead. Are you curtsy. What you're gonna do is give me three pulses, and then we're gonna lift the knee in front of the arm. Point the toe, it's three. Two, lift the knee, point the toe. Three, two, lift the knee, point the toe. So it just comes in front of the body, kind of at an angle, just directly in front of that arm. Again, three, two, lift the knee, point your toe. Three, two, knee, point the toe. We'll do one more after this, and then I want you to hold that knee up. Are you ready? Hold it, hold it. Point your toe, point and bend. Extend and bend. Let's take this arm, bring it in front of the body. Really squeeze the belly, squeeze the glutes. We have two more. We're gonna bring this knee on the inside. Bring it under the arm to the inside, and then under the arm to the outside. We'll do three of these. One more. All right, go ahead, take your ankle over the dog. Sit the hips back. We're gonna come back to that curtsy. If bending the knee and pointing the toe felt good, stay there. If you want just a little bit more, we're gonna straighten the leg, okay? Same thing, it's gonna be three pulses, and you can either just lift and bend the knee, or we're gonna straighten the leg and point the toe. Ready? Here we go, three pulses. It's three, two, extend, point the toe. Three, two, one, three, two, one. We have one more, one more. We're going eight singles. Here we go. Eight, seven, six. Halfway there. Stay with me. Two and one. I want you to take that leg behind, push your heel into the floor, and then reach this arm over your head. Before we switch sets. Everything we did on the other side, we're just going to repeat. Drop and pulse for three. Take the arm out. Three, two. We're going to bring that arm overhead. Relax the shoulder. Three, two. I want you to squeeze the inner thighs. Squeeze the glutes. Pull your belly into your spine. Just reminding you. Seven, six, five, enjoyed it. I hope you had fun. So my name's Courtney, and I teach classes all throughout the day, hip hop, level one and two. I do HIIT classes and Barre. I'm so glad that Headsweats gave me the opportunity to reach even more people, because this is what I love to do, and I'm so thankful that you guys joined me this morning. Okay, if anybody has any questions, let me know. Otherwise, have a great rest of your day.